Welcome back to Ferris Sports Update. Time to talk men's basketball. I'm with us head coach Andy Bronkema. Coach, first of all, welcome to the show.
Thanks.
Certainly a tough ending for the Bulldogs, but a great postseason run as you reach the NCAA Division II Sweet 16.
It was a heck of a run, and five do-or-die games in a row, and when you win that many in a row where it's win or go home, it's a lot of fun. It's real exciting.
Talk about the turnaround you had here in the postseason. You lost those five in a row to in the regular season, but five straight victories here in the postseason, winning the GLIAC tournament and then winning your first two games of the NCAA tournament.
Yep, we kept talking about being one click away, so we just clicked it over and found a way to win some games. And certainly that shot by Cushenberry at Finley, having that thing roll in at the buzzer, really gave us our legs back, made us a dangerous team, and we just capitalized from there. That was a tough stretch for us, and things were just going the wrong way, and couldn't really put our finger on it. But we stuck with it, and the seniors and the team, they didn't lose hope. You always have hope, and we went on a nice run.
You won the first two games of the NCAA tournament, beat Bellarmine University, beat Indianapolis, and then taking on Saginaw Valley State here in the regional final. As we go to some of the footage, talk about that long stay, that extended stay, and getting the opportunity to play in a regional final.
Well, we stayed as long as we could. We had a hotel switch there in between, thank goodness. But playing two teams that you haven't played in the regular season was kind of nice. A new film study, some new blood, and they didn't know us inside and out, so that was kind of nice, and we came out firing, but we were able to create some open shots, and that was nice to be open and uncovered a little bit. And those were two big games and led to this game here against Saginaw, meeting number three, which is the regular season champion of our league, and a team that we've had some great battles with over the years, and pretty much one of those games where we knew everything about them and they knew it all about us, and it came down to the end, them making a couple more plays and then sinking their free throws, and we wouldn't go away easy, but 2-point victory for Saginaw, and they're moving on to the Elite Eight, and they're going to represent our conference well.
Bulldogs with some strong showing in terms of fan support, making the trip out to Wisconsin as well, as we saw during the pregame, but had some nice fans that made the trip here.
Very thankful for the people that made the trip, and they're more than fans. The people that make all those games, it's family, and if they're not blood family, then they become the Bulldog family real easily. So they've embraced this team, and this group of seniors, they've been following them for a while, and it's been a heck of a run, and I think we did them proud.
Bulldogs and the Cardinals here both back and forth through the first half, tied at halftime. Neither team really shoot the ball as well as you had the first two games of the regional tournament, but partly due to the defensive effort by both teams.
Yeah, good defensive effort, and when you're that familiar with the other team's personnel, their skill set, and all of their plays, Randy and I could have switched spots and just called the plays for the opposite teams if we wanted, I'm sure. And then there was a little nerves early, just two teams being to the Sweet 16 for the first time of all these players. Obviously our program's been there before, but Saginaw's up and coming, the first time that they've been in the national tournament, making a nice run.
Bulldogs with a great start here to the second half, outscoring the Cardinals 9-1 early, and you took an 8-point lead here in the ballgame.
Yeah, we just couldn't hold on to it, and a credit to Saginaw. They got out on the break a few times, with some runouts, and thought we did a pretty good job of preventing those, but it was literally just the difference between a play here and there and the timing of the plays. You're going to see a little later in these highlights. Here's one of the runouts. Travel, no travel, I don't know. Looked like a pretty good Euro step, perhaps. But and then they have a big tip in at the end, and they drain some free throws. But just the timing of their plays that they made at the end, and us missing a few. And that's what championship basketball is all about, making some tough plays when it counts.
You mentioned making some free throws. They hit some free throws, but your kids kind of like all season, never quit and really kept battling back and still had an opportunity here at the end to possibly win the basketball game.
Oh, we battled. We battled hard. This wasn't any case of any flukes or anything crazy. Saginaw kind of had our number this year, and so credit goes to them. We couldn't defeat them. We gave it everything we had. We'd love another opportunity, but that's not what we get this year. We have to wait till next year to compete, and we're already looking forward to next year's team, and we got the banquet coming up, so we can celebrate this year's team.
Obviously, here in the regional final, four seniors ending their careers. Talk about what they have meant here to Bulldog basketball.
We have to do a whole another separate show for if we had enough time to talk about, you know, their greatness. And you know, I think the thing we're most proud about is we were together as a family and we did some important things as a team and some accomplishments, but just the perspective we were able to keep it in and to know where it lies on the list of priorities in our life. And so I'm most proud about that. These guys got good head on their shoulders and I'm comfortable sending them off and, you know, them going to the next stage of their life. But as far as contribution to the Bulldog basketball program, you know, you can make an argument that it's, you know, one of the best groups ever.
Bulldogs with back-to-back 20-win seasons, back-to-back NCAA tournament appearances, conference tournament championships. Just talk about the past 2 years and how fun it's been for your program.
Yeah, we got to write it down. It's too lengthy to memorize now. I mean, I can't even think of all the things that we've done the last couple of years that were either the first time ever or never been done before or first time in 25 years. Or I mean, the streaks we've had, the things we've done, the big games we've played in, and the big games we've played in and lost. I mean, the experiences we've had the last couple of years have been a lot of fun, and I'm glad that those guys get to keep those the rest of their lives, and they become legendary.
How important is it to get those experiences for some of your younger guys here that made some big contributions here in the postseason?
Well, we got a good nucleus coming back, and we lose a lot. You know, I calculated all the stats that we lose: 109 minutes, 44.2 points per game, 23.9 rebounds. I mean, 9.5 assists. It goes on and on. So it's daunting when you think about the stats we lose. But what helps you is just the knowledge we have of the incoming recruits, the red shirts, the players that are willing to expand their roles and work hard in the offseason. So I couldn't be more excited about the future of this program and where we're going. And, you know, we're going to make a good run at what we hope is a three-peat and see where it falls.
Bulldogs head into the offseason. What are some goals here in the offseason as you get ready for another year coming up in the fall?
Well, we have some, we're going to narrow it down. We're not quite done with that evaluation process. We've had some end of the year meetings scheduled, and we just got to take a look at what it's going to take to win this league and who's going to have to do what for us. So some guys are going to be slotted into some specific roles. Other guys, we're going to have to project a little bit and see what we can develop them into. But we're reaching for the stars, and you know, if we reach for the stars, we're going to grab them.
Well, Coach, congratulations again on a great season for the Bulldogs and a tremendous finish here in the postseason.
Appreciate it.
That's going to do it for Ferris Sports Update. A reminder, you can follow all the action online and get all the updates at ferrisstatebulldogs.com. Have a great week.